I'm Randy Weiss, Small Grain Specialist at NC State University. It's March 11th, and this crop alert about Hessian fly is made possible by the Small Grain Growers Association. We've seen symptoms of Hessian fly in the southern and central coastal plains and in the tidewater regions. I took this picture about mid-February in a field near Lumberton. This is a Hessian fly resistant variety that's looking healthy and well tillered. A few feet away, this is one of our most popular high yielding varieties that happens to be susceptible to Hessian fly. Notice how thin the stand is and the presence of dying tillers. If we zoom in on these thin areas, you can see a dead tiller right next to one that is green, and a few inches away, a completely dead tiller that is decomposing. Carefully digging up that tiller, here is what we found. This is the first root coming off the base of the stem. Here is the stem and first leaves that are completely rotted due to Hessian fly feeding. And here is the flax or the fly pupa or flax seed. So if you have wheat that is thin and has lots of sickly or dying tillers, and when you dig up these sickly plants, you find these flax seed, that's the giveaway that you have a Hessian fly infestation. What control options are there? We don't have any reliably good options. Sometimes a pyrethroid insecticide sprayed when the adults hatch from the flax seeds helps, and sometimes it doesn't. The difficulty is that we don't have a good way to predict when the flies will hatch, which is when the insecticide needs to be sprayed. A period of sustained warm weather is probably needed. We're currently having a few days of warm weather, but the forecast is calling for temperatures to drop again later this week, and these fluctuating temperatures make it difficult to time that insecticide spray. If you're concerned about Hessian fly and controlling it, look at this short management video that can be found online at www.smallgrains.ncsu.edu and click on the Video Library tab. Finally, both this Hessian fly management video and the crop alert you're currently watching are made possible with funding from the North Carolina Small Grain Growers Association.